आरंभ होइछे वर्ल्ड यूनिवर्सिटी समिट 2021 समिट को उद्घाटन करिछन्ते उपराष्ट्रपति वेंकैया नायडु। एतरे जोगदे केन्द्रमंत्री धर्मेन्द्र प्रधान कहिछन्ते सारा विश्व रे शिक्षार हब हेबो भारत, एणिके शिक्षा रे बाधक हेबनि भाषा। भाषा कारणरु कौनसी छात्र छात्री शिक्षारु वंचित हेबेनि। 21-23 जुलाई पर्यंत चलिबो एही कार्यक्रम। एतरे 100 रु अधिक यूनिवर्सिटी सामिल हेबे। जोगदेबे 25 देश सह 6 महादेशर 150 लीडर।
It gives me great pleasure to be here today at the World University Summit organized by OP Jindal Global University. As universities across the world overcome the challenge of ongoing pandemic to ensure academic continuity, this summit on the theme Universities of the Future, Building Institutional Resilience, Social Responsibility and Community Impact is indeed timely. I believe that we have a congregation today of over 150 thought leaders, including vice chancellors, presidents, rectors and provosts from over 100 universities across 25 countries. I want to congratulate the organizer for managing a gathering of this scale. Friends, India has a long history of higher education. The higher education system we have inherited after independence was designed and established during the colonial times. India today has a population of about 1.38 billion people, generating unparalleled demographic dividends. Our realities today, therefore, are starkly different from that of 70 years ago. In today's age of globalization and liberalization, we must reform the education sector and ensure that we achieve goals that are aligned with the development and growth of the nation. With its diverse and complex landscape. I'm delighted to share with you that as India reimagined the transformation of its education landscape to adapt to these times, we witnessed a new education policy in 2020 that has unveiled a new imagination for the Indian higher education.
Along with the Swayam Prabha, a group of 32 direct-to-home DTH channels devoted to the telecast of educational programs round the clock. Yet, the virtualization of education is not easy and comes with its own set of challenges. As we are aware, in India, not everyone has access to the internet, a computer, and other digital infrastructure. Even if the infrastructure issues are resolved, can we ever substitute the classroom teaching experience with an online class? The teaching not only simply content delivery, we must understand the interaction between the teacher and the student. One has to go beyond the content to understand the assumptions, theory, and the implications of the content. Also, the classroom alone does not represent the school. I am of the opinion the student should spend half of the time in classroom, remain half in the field. The latest study also indicates a dangerous trend of myopic developing among the children if you continuously watch the net attached to the phone. It will create eyesight problems. That is what the experts are saying. So they are suggesting that in between the online class, the students must go out and spend time with the nature. Sports and extracurricular activities along with arts and crafts also form an integral part of holistic education. Clearly, virtual education cannot be substituted for conventional classroom teaching and learning. Therefore, in the near future, we need to explore the possibility of a hybrid teaching model by combining the best practice of offline and online education to get the optimum learning outcomes, a model which the learner and the teacher would find both interactive and interesting. It should provide students with a knowledge that base that prepares them to learn independently and creatively. Through proactive critical thinking, learners should be molded into readers in their chosen fields so that eventually they evolve into drivers of social change. The COVID-19 pandemic pushed us to innovate faster than ever before, and these innovations in the discipline of education can help us build a more equitable system of teaching and learning. However, we need to constantly improve and upgrade the online academic ecosystem. The increased use of artificial intelligence in education technology could bring it closer to real life learning experience. You must focus on that. I hope this conference will focus enough on this aspect. We should also utilize this opportunity to provide learner-centered education to every child. I believe that with artificial intelligence and big data, we can build user-friendly tools that can enrich the teaching learning experience significantly. Furthermore, we should explore the possibility of using online education tools in skill training and adult education. This is also equally important. If used effectively, this may enhance the skills and employability of our huge youth population. To make online educational tools effective, there is a need to train all stakeholders and ensure availability of technology and related resources by bridging the digital divide. Only then digital education can become truly inclusive and accessible. Technology also provides immense possibilities for educational cooperation among academics, universities, and countries. We must learn from each other's experience. We must follow best practices. One can be situated in a small suburb in Canada and learn yoga from a teacher based in rural Haryana. Collaborative research, joint classes, and student projects are several options already being pursued at some levels. This process can be fast-tracked with the active involvement of the industry. There has to be industry-academic collaboration for the betterment of the nation. This is already there in certain...